take a look at a play with J.J. Redick within the moment and really understand the details of this play. Now, this type of play is extremely controversial, and people can say that this only can happen in the NBA. You can really study other levels of the game, such as Europe basketball, Chinese basketball, and so on, to really see that in international basketball, this type of stuff does occur. And really, officials are trained to look for one thing when it comes to travel calls, when the basketball is physically picked up. Now, I don't want to talk about zero steps and things like that and muddy the water. We're just going to talk about pickups and the flow of the game. So we'll start off in an exaggerated play where J.J. Redick catches a pass, bobbles a little bit, which is going to hang up some people. But once he finally gets control, he quickly gets it down. And so that would be avoiding a travel call already. Now, from this moment in time, he's going to sync up that dribble. We're going to see 1, 2, 3, 4 total steps to pick up the basketball. Now, it's very difficult to get in sync with the flow and the timing when you're doing it slow. But one thing I want you to understand is that once he puts the basketball down, he's going to take 2 steps while the ball is simply in a float position. Now, from an official standpoint, the official is waiting to see if he dribbles again, because JJ never comes underneath the basketball. He doesn't dribble too high. If he did this and he's just running, he can always dribble again. 2 steps in between dribbles happens all the time when players are getting downhill. And so, and I'm talking about all levels, because an official is not counting the amount of steps that a player is taking while the ball is being dribbled. And so, if he took this dribble and he takes those 2 steps in between, now he starts to pick the basketball up. At that moment in time, good officials are trained to have their eyes go to the ball, to the feet. And so now they can count not 4 steps, but 2 steps. So those first 2 steps are simply hidden. They're motion steps that are occurring underneath the surface that no one's paying attention to, until, of course, we rewind the tape, watch in slow motion, and really count all those steps that occur. Now, obviously, you could see this in live and maybe see that he took a lot of steps, but if your eye's not looking at the pickup, you're not really counting the correct amount of steps or the starting point. Because if you counted the full length of steps that JJ ran, it was plenty more than 4. And so when does the count start? The count starts when the ball is physically picked up. So he catches the ball, he syncs up, he has 2 steps, and now he picks it up with 3 and 4, which now are the 2 steps that he has to complete that deep range ball that he hits all the time in the flow of the game.
If you take a snapshot of a player making a move, you can really dissect things. The position of the foot, the positions of the defensive player. You know, you can break things down. If you're seeing a game move so quickly, a lot of times you can't, right? So with a still image, you can really pick things apart.